Hi everyone, it's Asia Marke here with my vintage project for Lindisgang. Today I'm gonna be working mostly with Moon Shadow Sprays from Lindis, one of my very favorite products from Lindis. And I'm starting by preparing the page. I recently bought this journal, it's a craft paper journal. The pages are not very sturdy, so I'm applying the heavy gesso to it. And I also don't know for now what kind of creations I can do on the craft paper itself, so I prefer to actually change the background a little and have it in white. And I'm gonna do some stamping. This is my home or handmade stamp with triangles. And this is the page which is kind of a following of a page I've done over a year ago, I think already, with also Tim Holtz dolls, paper dolls, and some of the geometrical stamping. I will try to put the link in the description box below to the other video. And so this one is with triangles, the first one was with circles, and basically what I'm doing now is adding stamping. And I also did some masking using a post-it note, which allowed me to stamp the texture stamp or the crackle stamp without going inside the triangles itself. And the next stamp I'm gonna be using, one of my very favorite one, it's a collage elements from Rubber Dance. And what I'm doing basically, and what I'm usually doing anyway, it's stamping. The beginning of my art journaling, it's usually stamping. So I add as much texture to the background as I possibly can. And now I'm using all type of stamps I can find lying around, with mostly with triangles. There are some circles, of course. This stamp I'm using right now, it's a stamp from Viva Las Vegas stamps. And as you see me, and if you know me, you know the distress is the way for me to go. So let's add some colors. I have two sprays now, and one of them is French Lilac Violet, which is actually Starburst, and the other is the Moon Shadow Mist, and it's called Violaceous Violet. And I'm gonna start with adding some water to the page in the places I want the paint to go, because I'm gonna be using the paints a little bit as the watercolors. So firstly, I'm adding a Moon Shadow Mist. And Moon Shadow Mist here, it looks brown. Nothing spectacular about it, just a very nice color. But wait and see how it looks when it's actually dry. I'm adding also a Starburst, which is violet, and which is gonna dry, of course, like a violet. And now I'm gonna add some open amethyst on the side of the stamps. But what's important about Moon Shadows, and what I like, let me come back to the Moon Shadows now, it's the fact that if you shake them well and make the color dilute itself properly in the bottle, after drying you're gonna get a double color. You're gonna get this brownish hint, but you're also gonna get the other color, which is advertised on the bottle, on the sticker, which is on the bottle. In this case, it's a violet one. And maybe you don't see it clearly right now, but you will see it in the close-ups. The very bright violet color, it's of course the French Lilac Violet, but you'll see also in between, in the brown, the hint of violet, which is really beautiful. Moon Shadows Mists are actually one of my favorites. This is a kind of experimental page to me because I wanted to do a vintage project. I know I'm gonna be using paper dolls by Tim Holtz, but I've never used a vintage with violet and brown. So that's that. And now I'm wondering why I actually did not use embossing powder in the brown color, but I guess I wanted to add some contrast, so I'm not sure if the brown color would work perfectly, but I'm using obviously black Lindy's embossing powder, and I'm adding again triangles. I thought the page is not filled up enough with the triangles, so let me add some more of them. And I used a wow embossing pad, and I'm removing the excess of the powder in the places I don't like with the dry brush, and I'm gonna heat set everything. And a good advice for you when you are embossing, and probably I'm repeating myself, but it's nice to know the tricks. If you start embossing within these powders, it's with any powder, embossing powder anyway, it's good to start on the low setting of the heat gun, like that the powder doesn't fly away, because sometimes the embossing pads we have, they get dirty with time, or they are not very new, so the powder does not stick properly, and that's why it's better to start with the low setting on the heat gun. And so now I am working on my focal point. The focal point is the lady from Tim Holtz doll, which I around her I wrapped a wire, and then I'm gonna add a piece of from midform casting, which I am now covering with the black gesso, and I'm using crow's nest copper. That's another Moonshadow mist with a golden tint to it from Lindy's Gang, to add some color to it. When I'm happy with my placement, I'm gluing everything with a 3D matte gel, which is very good because it holds the heavy elements, and my wire is gonna go underneath the triangle brads, and a little bit of touches with metallic wax from Finavar. So now I was adding some golden paint, name of which I cannot really pronounce, don't ask me to do that. And since I have a lot of leftovers, I put it on the in my other art journal to use it in the future. And this project already actually it's done and up on my channel. And to add the finishing touches, I'm adding some clipping stickers from Tim Holtz, and drawing a little bit with my Uniball black pencil. Not pencil, a pen, I'm sorry. And that's it. I wish you a super nice crafty day, and I hope to see you soon. Bye!